Yo.
Hi, it is Dutch Bushcraft Lives, and today we have a shit episode for you guys, yeah? A shit episode, huh?
Why is that, Mickey? Why is that?
Because, look, the place where we normally are staying in and are living in looks like this. Wait for the thing to clip. No, I'm not going to do it. Yeah.
What's going on? Help!
Yeah, Mickey has actually been digging holes around my cabin.
Yeah, and we're gonna fill it up with water and crocodiles, so it's gonna be a very cool place.
Yeah, we are in construction because I'm getting a new cabin for these roots. Where are we going to live in? Yeah, that's it.
So today we have a different video.
Because we didn't have time!
No, because it is a very good idea, Martin.
Yeah, and we were...
We do not show our weaknesses to the audience.
Oh, sorry. But we were...
Dancing? We are gonna look at knives that YouTubers use. And we're gonna correct them if necessary. And it is bloody necessary. Because I've never seen anybody use a good knife except Linus Tech Tips. So let's go.
Yeah, that guy used a great knife. So...
Oh, is the video started now?
Nee.
Hello!
Yeah, so now we're in my room, ready to make this episode. Yeah, this very cool episode, which we are very proud of that we have to make because
such
of
a production.
The,
such an amazing production.
Yeah, because you are getting a new bungalow, Maarten.
A moving house, it's very hectic, Mickey.
Yeah, hopefully in next week the video will be like this again. Yeah, and otherwise, you can rape us. Okay, first of all, we're gonna look at the knives of a bunch of YouTubers or famous people.
Yeah.
Let's ready go. First of all...
One of my favorite YouTubers, Mickey.
Probably personally. The only YouTuber that I actually watch. Yeah, because I don't really watch other YouTubers that much. But this guy's a legend. Linus Tech Tips.
Crazy. And...
Luke!
Luke even has a DBK shirt! Woo!
These are smart people. Look at, let's look at Linus.
Oh, those two.
Okay, finally. Okay,
you can already see the bloody knife in his hands.
I think it's a Spyderco, Mickey. Definitely a Spyderco.
Yeah.
But that the Spyderco ladybug.
Actually, these knives are pretty okay.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Especially for unboxing. And I think Linus has a lot of unboxing to do.
Yeah, but Martin, I can't find that video, but I know that Linus has... a video where he has a Higanokami knife.
Really?
Yeah, he has a little Higanokami knife and I've seen it. This guy is smart, so it doesn't surprise me that this guy is the only YouTuber I have seen with a great knife.
And especially Luke, he's really smart.
Yeah, and pretty. I have never seen this guy.
Probably everybody on this channel knows him.
He only has 1.1 million views, Mark. I thought
Yeah. Nice one, Mick. It is actually 1 million subscribers. Idiot, ugly Belson.
But I choose this guy because I know probably a lot of our viewers know this guy.
Okay, Mark.
So his name is Wranglestar.
I'll give you the benefit of the doubt.
This guy is a homesteader and he has a very nice haircut. Don't give this man a mustache with his haircut.
Okay.
There we go.
It's a knife.
It's a knife. It's definitely a knife. He's cutting up the box. Slicing the shite.
So what knife is that, Martin?
I think it's a Benchmade.
It is a Benchmade. Let me see.
The Benchmade 940. What steel does it have?
It has
CPM S30V or CPM S90V. That's pretty crazy.
It's both really good, actually.
Hey, Mickey, Benchmade is hiring. Benchmade of you. Mickey's looking for a job.
The next guy. Is someone who has influenced a lot of YouTubers. I don't know if he has influenced this channel, but
I used to watch this guy quite a lot for maybe some inspiration for making videos.
Peter McKinnon! Yeah! What a great guy! Yeah.
So here's where my friend Lucas Burnley enters the game. See, he creates custom knives, he creates custom designs, he licenses some of those designs to companies, but he is a true artist with what he does. And you guys know me, you know this channel. I shouldn't wave that around. I love people that are creative in totally unique fields.
I am
Creative.
I am special. Creative. Interesting, Maarten.
You know why? We all know why you are special, Mickey. It's because your mother never planned to give birth to you.
I know. That's the harsh reality. That is the harsh reality. He says Lucas Burnley. Well, yeah. We looked that up. Burnley. Lucas Burnley knife. Yeah. Burnley knife.
What steel did he use? Like
I sent him a message asking him what steel did you use for Peter McKinnon's knife, and his He didn't answer me.
He didn't answer me either, so don't buy this guy.
No, but I mean, the knife seemed pretty good, and I like the fact that he actually, has a little knife thing going on, this Peter McKinnon.
Yep.
Smart guy!
But, Mickey...
Smart guy!
Something that I noticed over these last few years is that a lot more people like knives than you actually realize.
Yeah, I know.
Like, a few weeks ago, I had a girl on the phone asking for a new mobile contract, and it was on the Dutch Bushcraft knives, the contract.
Yeah.
And then she said, knives? Do you do something with knives? Oh, so fun! I have a whole knife collection! I was like, what?
Did she know us?
No, she didn't know us.
The bitch.
Then, what I like is most people have probably seen Duo Survival, that series.
Yep.
Odeon Dean uses the Mora 1.
Yeah.
The Mora number 1. That's because he does stuff like this. I'll show you.
Start to flex this tree. It's gonna come. You guys just go over there. I'm gonna put my blade in it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna push down and I'm gonna rock the.
Well, anyway, Mora number 1.
Yeah.
Nice, Cody. That's a smart idea. I don't know if you would know that you would need one survival knife. I wouldn't say it would be very smart using a Mora number 1. I mean, it's okay, but he has the choice to go out and take one knife, Maarten, one.
Yep.
And I would advise someone that if you can plan it.
You're even making my ears deaf with this headphone on.
Oh, Maarten, it's an insult.
I wouldn't take this knife, but no. I think it's really cool. I think it's really cool that Cody uses this knife instead of any other fancy looking knife that would be a hit on TV.
And
he used this classic Mora.
And Maarten, really cool. I don't really feel that I should give the man advice about his knife because he's probably 10 times a better bushcrafter than I am.
Yeah.
Okay. Next one.
Dave Canterbury. So this guy was like characterized as a big army guy on Dual Survival.
Yeah.
But in reality, I think he is more towards a bush guy or more like Cody Landin that you would actually realize.
Once again, it's got a black stem.
He looks so much different than on the series.
Yeah.
Anyway, the knife that he used on the series.
Yeah.
He uses multiple knives now. Is the Battle Horse.
Yeah, and I think he actually even designed his own knife together with Battle Horse. It was called Blind Horse at first.
Okay, let's pretend that we're watching a video of Dave Canterbury now.
Yeah, teaching a class. Wow! On the ground.
You rock, man!
That's unbelievable! Okay, then of course we have the very beautiful, but not as beautiful as this ugly bastard, Justine. Oh yes! And she has a new unboxing knife, and I know exactly what it is. Oh my god, what's this?
Let's start small. So I got this one recently too. It's super cool. It's
okay. So first of all, she starts with like this kind of folding knife that you would find in an army surplus store for children.
Yeah. I feel like I'm playing CS:GO.
But that's the thing. I think she has all these CS:GO kind of knives.
Yeah. And of course, this nice Rambo Bowie. Look at
this.
So this is something that, as a kid, I would have loved to have.
Definitely clear some brush with this too. But this is...
No, you cannot, Justine. Listen, you don't want to clear stuff out with that knife.
No, definitely not.
You want to buy good knife. But Maarten, instead of bashing these people about their wrong knife choice, which is very understandable, and they only use it to open boxes, so don't
very
worry.
Very nice pose of Christine in this.
Oh yeah, nice. yeah, better. What knife would we recommend to this pretty girl?
I think she does a lot of unboxing.
Marta, wait. I know which knife. She likes unboxing. She likes folding knives, apparently. And she likes the militaristic design, or just a little bit.
Yeah.
What do you think of the RA02?
She likes
extreme
big
ratio.
Yeah, extreme ratio RA2. That would definitely suit her.
The greatest folder ever made. the toughest folder ever made.
Might not be the most practical for unboxing, but it suits her. I mean, this is not practical. And she has one other knife.
Let me just say that I call her a pretty girl, and now I feel sexist because I didn't call the guys pretty guys. Who says that I don't find Dave Canterbury a very pretty man?
The cheapest shit knife that I ever had. It's this knife. I use it 99% of the time for unboxing.
Yeah.
Because it's so low profile on my keychain.
And do you keep this keychain in your bloody pocket?
Yeah.
You must be Arnold Schwarzenegger. These legs of this guy.
Look at it.
Oh my god. You're like a prisoner, Martin, with a chain strap to your leg. I often use my Victorinox, which I have lost about four of. So now I don't have an unboxing knife anymore, and then I probably mostly use my car key, which I always have with me. So that's the situation in Dutch Bushcraft Knives. And thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for watching this bloody video. It was very entertaining, and our whole channel will evolve around these kind of videos because we are stupid. We are stupid people. Oh. Please check out our Patreon because we are giving a good knife away every month.
It's a Melanica! Bushcrafter and Crewer.
Very nice.
And of course, a more Garbuk.
What a fun video! It was so funny! Martin, this might be my favorite kind of videos. Thank you very much for watching. And please press that subscribe button if you want more rubbish like this.
And. Bye.
Bye.